Hi guys,
hey.
I'm here with Dan and Yasin, the proud owner of a new M Super X, and he's allowing us to check it out. Thought I'd show you some of the options. We've been studying it for a little bit, comparing it next to Dan's original M Super V3. Just a few observations I'll make. You guys can chime in if I'm missing something, but the shell is definitely the same as the original M Super with, you know, modified visuals, but it's the same basic shell. Looks like they did widen the opening here by, best I can tell, is a 1/16 to an 1/8 of an inch, but it's really enough to, it looks like there's plenty of clearance. It's not like it's crammed in there that's going to be catching debris. It seems like the shell overall is wider though. So, must be these side panels somehow. Just a little bit wider. It's hard to quantify at this point. You know, it's kind of hard to get a tape measure on these guys. Oh, another observation, which you fellow M Super owners will appreciate, is they put a cutout here, so there's no longer it's no longer an awful job to pump air into the tire. The tire is a 3-inch wide tire versus a 2.5-inch on the original M Super. I measured the diameter, and it's 19.5 inches on the M Super V3. It's 18.75. And the tire literally is an 18 by 3-inch tire. So Gateway's marketing of a 19-inch tire is,
nah. You said 18.5, right? I thought we measured 19.5.
No, this is 19.5.
Yeah.
But this one is 18.75.
Yeah.
So it's definitely a beefier tire, and 3 inches, a 3-inch wide tire, that's a substantial jump. I mean, it looks really beefy. These side panels, pads, they're very thin relative to the original M Super, and they are fitted on here properly. But the adhesive, it's pretty crappy. It's kind of typical, maybe Gateway fit and finish. Might be able to correct that with put some aftermarket double-sided tape on it. So yeah, it's just, I'm not sure about those side pads. And they kind of look thin. I guess it'll be interesting to try that, not today, but at least when I get mine, to try this on the mountains, to see what kind of grip. It kind of depends on the power of the motor in terms of climbing hills. On a current M Super, you got to squeeze the pads to get some leverage to climb. There's not much squeezing involved. This is a really thin pad. It's like almost like, what's its purpose?
Another thing you'll notice that we didn't discuss before is the angle of the pedals now.
Oh, yeah.
It's,
definitely. It's like the Tesla. They increased the dihedral angle on the Tesla to 8 degrees. Let's see if I can. I'm going to flip this camera around. Yeah, that's substantial, actually.
Oh, yeah.
And then the pedals are higher too, so the net effect is they must really feel.
You feel pretty high.
They must feel really high, huh?
You do. That's for going over big rocks, I guess.
Yeah, keep holding it like that. It's amazing. It's a really beefier looking wheel, even though the shell is essentially the same. That tire. I'm really interested in riding it to see the power too. Sure looks like it's a nice upgrade, and the LEDs are cool, and they definitely, the back LEDs these are different type of LEDs than the originals, and they're multicolor too. These are only all red. I think it's mainly that this the plastic is red. Here it's a clear, more of a clear plastic, and they go what green? And you've observed green and okay, green and red.
Yeah, that's it. That's all I've seen.
And these LEDs kind of look colorful.
On this mode they turn with the wheel. On the other mode they just blink.
Okay. How many modes have you?
There's
found?
Three. There's the turning with the wheel. There's this blinking one and off.
Okay. And does it seem to remember the setting too when you turn?
It does actually. Okay. Surprisingly, I was surprised to notice that when I usually keep it off, but.
Yeah, in my MCM5, it remembers the setting,
okay.
too, so
that
it looks like
nice.
They're doing that on... And I heard the newer Teslas do that, too, remember the ring settings.
That's nice.
How's the weight feel to you? About this, a little heavier or hard to tell?
A little heavier. Barely heavier.
So... Yeah, and you have an M Super.
Yeah.
V3.
True.
Does it feel feel wider stance wise?
Yes, wider stance, and I hadn't driven a Tesla before, so there was a adjustment period between this and this one. I did have to get used to it.
And now that you've had it a whole day.
True, exactly. I did switch back. I tried this again last night, and it felt really, really loose and. I'm sure when you try it, you might be able to describe it a little better.
And how's the power feel to you?
Power feels
compared to your original.
The power is really exceptional on this one.
You can notice it. It's
definitely,
not like
unquestionably,
subtle.
Unquestionably, you can notice the definite power increase.
Well, I'm excited to the thought of a powerful, much more powerful M Super for mountain trails is exciting.
Nice,
definitely. And the width. It feels wider, but it's not. It's comfortable enough still.
I'm going to leave that to your
comments
after because I did notice that my legs were at least pushing on this
more
a little bit more. I might put some more padding or something there.
Okay.
But
or just get used to
different
stance.
Putting my feet a little bit wider maybe.
It's really interesting that those. That the dihedral angle on those pedals, it's really noticeable.
And you'll see why also, because you are spread out a little bit more. Why don't you get to riding?
So it's a... I know, it's a cool wheel. I'm really glad my order is in, and I really look forward to getting it. I know. I haven't ridden it, of course, yet, but the only negative are these side panels, and I'm not sure I like the color, too. I might... You can get some paint. I remember one of the guys posted some rubber, some paint that's good for foam that you can spray.
Yeah.
I might try that in mine. And so, very cool.
Very cool.
All right, well, we're going to switch the wheels around and do some riding around here for a bit and get some of it on film, too. All right, guys, see you in a bit. Okay, so Yasin's going to... Do the community a favor and open up the shell. We were talking about these vent holes. There's three in the front and three in the back. I was just wondering if they're real or fake, like the MCM5. They look like they're real. They can actually pass air. So, I can tell right away that they're still not putting Loctite on these threaded inserts. So those come off pretty easy. It'd be interesting to see the brass. I assume they're probably brass inserts, which is such an improvement. It's so nice that Gatway finally is updated the mechanics inside. It's interesting, so there's more screws.
I guess I'm missing those two up here.
Hopefully they don't have any end of it.
Yeah.
They got this one and this one, so.
Kingsong puts screws under the pads, which is a real pain.
The monster has three of them right there.
But they're not under the pads.
So yeah, they're
on
the right here.
No. Yeah, my 100-volt monster has a screw here, here, and here.
You have a 100-volt monster?
Yeah.
When did you get that?
A couple of weeks ago, so this guy gets a 100-volt monster.
Doesn't
tell anyone. He could have brought that with him today, so we could have tried that out. You know?
When you're having too much fun racing around, you don't think about telling anyone.
So now I got to make another trip down here to see Dan's 100-volt monster.
That's true.
You're holding on to this, man. I'd really like to try that. I'm really curious about that. Because you didn't have the other monster.
No, I didn't. I tried it a couple times, and I was intimidated by the original monster both times, because I would lean forward like I do all my other wheels, and it would take some time for that monster to catch up to me.
Yeah.
And that's what intimidated me. This thing is just staying back there, even though I'm leaning. But then I found that, oh yeah, you just grab it with your legs, and you demand it, and it gives it to you. It just accelerates that nicely.
I can't believe this guy got 100-volt monster and didn't tell anyone.
Yeah, when I first got on it, I was thinking, this thing's not accelerating like I would want it to, I think. But then I changed my mind after I rode it about 84 miles. I just fell in love.
And what's the battery on this?
1850.
That's still pretty, that's still decent. And you said you've got 80 miles, 80 some, or
I think I've ridden 84 miles.
On one charge?
Oh, no, not on one charge. I only ride it partial charge every day. Yeah, 1850 watt hours would get me hours of being tired.
Yeah.
And I've never taken it on a long ride. Yep. I'm replacing the rear LED strip. That's why I didn't bring it today.
Yeah.
What happened?
I sprayed water on the top section, and they have those four spare ports. And the right front port is right over the speaker, and the main board, and a new board that didn't exist on the original monster. The new monster, the 100-volt, has a new board right in here.
Okay.
In addition to the main board on the side. And so the water drops got, a few water drops got on the buzzer and on the main board and on possibly on the board that's in here.
Okay.
But the LED strip doesn't plug into here, it plugs into the main board.
Okay.
And I unplugged it and it has 5 volts on the red wire and 0.39 volts on the white wire relative to the black. And I don't know if that's normal or not, but I'm going to plug a new LED strip in there before I decide whether to tear it all apart and replace the main board.
But I don't know
yet where I'm going to go with that.
But something broke. I mean, the strip.
Oh, yeah, the water intrusion caused something to burn out. And the only function that didn't return after, I should say that after I sprayed my wheel, which was de-energized, it turned itself on several times. And the buzzer was going off randomly, the headlight was flashing randomly, and it was turning itself on, and I was turning it off, and I would put it on its side, and it would turn itself on after some time. And they kept on doing this stuff, and hours later I had it apart, and it was finally the buzzing sound finally quit, and the light stopped blinking, and I put a hair dryer on it and dried everything off.
So check that out.
And then,
This is the back. It's going on like this.
Okay.
So we can verify that the inset of this is what matches this.
Okay.
So it's not like just stuck on
there. Right.
Interesting part about this is that these vent holes, which you can see that they have a bath to them, if they're not just straight through.
Right.
So what they've done is they've actually channeled it. They've made a, put a cover on, and then the air goes through this little, you see that little hole up there?
Oh.
So it actually is channeled, and then the same on the back.
But just, oh, so the water,
so water,
the water won't go up.
Water won't go
up. But the only air, it's just one spot.
Yeah, just one spot.
So it's
a
little bit of air.
True, a little bit of air.
So that's not going to be a bad water intrusion problem.
Exactly.
Yeah, when you get your MCIC racks, just don't hose it down.
Well, you know, I saw Ian on his video hose his monster.
Yeah, I never. Just never.
Had no problem. I've hosed all my wheels.
Can I get closer to them?
Yeah, clearly, it's definitely beefier, right? These posts.
Yeah. Oh, are they?
Oh, yeah.
Oh,
they're
yeah.
threaded. They're all threaded.
And they're
and
thick.
I mean, metal. They're metal inserted.
Yeah, they're metal.
Metal
I
inserts.
I can't. They look like they're brass.
It is
can't
quite
brass.
Sound.
Yeah. So, and but the posts are beefier.
Yeah, they did good with the threaded inserts and all that.
These are not going to snap.
And then the light. I guess the light.
Obviously, we didn't open the control board, so.
We still got to
so he's going to put
brand water in around the this part.
Right, here is the control board. We're going to try and get Yasin totally disassemble this wheel so we can look at the shims too.
But there is something different about that. I'm sure in the future we'll get to that.
Yeah, the shims, there's it kind of looks like the shims are black if that is the shims. It definitely looks a bit different. But,
control board. No more heat sink that pasted on there.
They put some
more capacitors.
They put stuff over the motor wire connection.
Ah, true. The three.
Oh yeah, they said these are now they're spring loaded. They're kind of a spring connection. So they're no longer. These aren't directly soldered to the board. They can
disconnect.
They can.
Yeah, interesting.
And they got the new ubiquitous little fan stuck on the side, which does something, I guess, but I don't know. They're on all their wheels now.
True.
Mine has a couple fans.
It's nice in here, though.
Yeah, it does.
Bluetooth.
It's now on top.
Yeah, it's now on top. Yeah. Yeah, the boards definitely look different.
Oh, and where's these side lights going?
Your Bluetooth was not on top?
My Bluetooth was sticking out that, like this way.
Yeah.
Very nice.
The board is bigger. It's bigger. Physically, it's a bigger board.
Yeah. I don't even notice on this, denotation, but it's still a 60-volt motor.
Yeah, who knows how that, what that really means. I just love the threaded inserts. So nice it got me changed. Now these machine screws, no more wood screws, essentially. We were commenting, by the way, on the older wheels, if you guys are missing any of the, quote, wood screws, they're number four, so if you need any replacements, just buy a number four wood screw, and that'll work for you.
Excellent.
All right, well, that was cool.
That answered a few questions of mine.
See, this means when I get mine, I won't have to do any of this.
Yes, exactly. True.
Thank you, Yasin.
Of course.
About circuitry around here.
Yeah, that's cool, guys. But hope you enjoyed this further look into the MCIC RX. Get your order in. They're going to be in short supply, I think.
I think so, too.